Well, if you ask me, sir, I would suggest you attend the meeting yourself. It will do our company a lot of good. That's actually my professional advisor. You're welcome, sir. I'm always at your service. Okay. Do have a nice day too. Bye. Hello, Jessica. Long queue. Okay, it's almost your turn. Okay. No, almost. I'm almost done. Yes. Just get the fuel, okay? I'm waiting. Be fast about it. And listen, Jessica, hold on. Don't forget to get the pizza. Yes. I'm waiting. Okay, bye. Thank you. 1 minute. I'm coming.
I hope you like this.
No, it's fine. I like it so much.
Ignite, please. Take it easy. Take your water. Take more.
I'm fine. Can you see the water for?
Bone?
What kind of bone is this?
But I selected the fish very well. Sorry, you.
I'm fine. It's okay.
It's okay. Daniela!
Hey!
No!
Mane amujara gweni isi! Hey!
Kisi no tutua! Ebe kisi no tutua!
I came to surprise you too.
How are you? I'm fine, thank you, Ne.
What? We enjoy it, but your arrival is unannounced, and why the sudden visit and then without your car? I hope all is well.
Papa, all is well.
What of your car? What of your sister, Jessica?
I did not come with my car.
I hope all is well.
All is well, Papa.
Okay.
Mama, how are you?
We're fine.
Yes. You're welcome. You can see.
Okay, let's go inside.
Rather, I would like you to prepare okra soup and pounded yam for me.
Oh,
what?
Is that what you want?
Okra soup and the pounded yam. Yes. What a combination! You're welcome, my dear.
I have to go now. I want to go and see Obinna, but I'll be back shortly.
This is wonderful.
Mama, there will be enough time to rest. I'll come back home. When I come back, I'll rest.
Pride of her father! Pride of her father. Hello, mom.
Adam.
Yes, you're here.
Adam.
Welcome. Yes.
One name with Jaraguan, you see?
No, you're welcome. Yes. You're welcome.
I'll be back.
Okay. Let me rush and get your suit.
It's alright.
Please come back on time, oh. You know?
Go. Be fast. Don't delay.
I will.
Go and make special okra soup and pounded yam. Hi.
Nobody should leave the site, okay? The people are coming. They'll supply the sand today. Tell them to hold on now. I don't understand. You'll see me very soon, don't worry. All right. Wow.
What is it?
Isn't all these boys at the site? Because we didn't have sand day before yesterday, I told them to take a day off. And then today they are waiting for the sand and the sand is nowhere to be found and they are angry. They want to leave the site. So I asked them to just wait there. Everyone is looking for an opportunity to go home.
It's okay now.
I don't understand the kind of youth we have these days. I'm just so lazy. I don't even know why Ella has not sent this money.
Master, she will send it.
No, I don't understand why you. Yeah? She has not... Ella. Hey.
Ella.
This one, you came unannounced like this. Let me get you a seat.
Hello. What is it? Did you quarrel or fight with anyone? This is unlike you walk into our compound without saying anything. How do you explain the movement of the toad in the afternoon when it's neither chasing something or something chasing it?
Ella, you're sounding weird right now.
Honestly.
Eh? Is there a problem? Is there something you want to talk about? I'm the best man. Talk to me.
Friends and family are considered a very powerful tool. That anyone who has them is lucky. But it hurts to know that nature will not allow one to enjoy to the brim. But who are we to question nature? Because nature has to take its course. Now, what are you saying? If I say I understand what you are saying, I will be the greatest liar of our time. But what is this?
Everything is all right, Ifoma. Obinna. Yes. Let me make the transfer as regards the sand and other things you said you'll be needing at the site.
Okay. But,
I forgot how bad network can be in this compound. But don't worry. Once I get to my father's house, I'll make the transfer. I have to go now. My mother has prepared a very delicious meal for me.
Ella, I'm still not comfortable with your behavior this morning. Is everything all right? Talk to me now. I'm your pal. I'm your best friend. You can talk to me. Huh?
Obinna, everything is all right. Everything is fine. Maybe I'm just hungry.
Hunger.
And I'm sure my mother should have been done with the cooking. So I have to go now so I can eat. But I want you two to know that I am very honored and blessed to have met you two in my lifetime. Friends like family, my sister and my brother. And if there is life after this life, I would want to have you two as my friend and my family again.
Ella, I'm not... I don't think I understand what you're doing. Or
it's confusing.
Are you trying to scare us here? I don't...
Obinna, take good care of yourself.
It's all right. I'm waiting for the transfer now.
Ifoma, I wish you safe delivery.
She has...
Thank you, Baba.
She has like 4 months to go.
Yes,
now.
We'll see you again, won't we?
Goodbye, my friends. I'll see you again.
I don't understand.
Nai. to look at her happy.
I should be happy.
Because you saw your daughter.
And you, are you not happy?
I am.
Is the food ready?
Almost. Almost done.
Almost. Mm. But be done very, very fast. Quickly.
But you know the food is not for you now.
I know it's not for you. Since
for
the daughter, what
Hey.
Is good for the daughter?
What is it?
What happened?
This is a terrible news.
What is terrible? Onaka, can you
speak? Can't you speak? Talk.
Hey, some assassins entered Daniela's house this morning. Shut her dead!
Ah! Shut up! What's again?
Jessica even collapsed. My...
What is he talking about?
No, are you. Have you gone out of yourself?
No, I'm not joking!
No. Who is joking with you? Yeah. No, what is your problem? Are you high on weed? Just tell me the truth.
No, no!
Are you high on weed?
I am serious, man!
Are you out of your senses? What is wrong with your head? Something is wrong, actually wrong in your head.
I'm not joking!
Well, Major, shut up your mouth and get out of my compound.
Daniela that left here a few minutes ago to go and see Obinna. And what are you talking about? The items she bought for us are still here. If you like, go in and see for yourself. The food on the fire is being prepared for her. So what is your problem?
Daniela.
Somebody brought you...
Onaka, so this is your level of wickedness over my daughter?
No, Mama.
No. What did she do to you?
Nothing.
Tell me the exact thing that warrants this type of hatred for you to announce the death of a living. No. Tell me. The Daniela that just left my house now to go and see her friend Obinna was shot dead at the city.
Daniela.
It's your daughter. Let death pursue you to the grave.
Hold on.
Come on, get out.
I said the items she bought for us are here. Daniela left here a few minutes ago. Will I be repeating myself for you? What is your problem?
Get out of this compound.
I know what I'm saying.
What? Come on, get out.
Just show me your bag.
Get out.
Bogui Webi Burazu. Just turn and leave this place. Get out of my compound, I said.
Please, I know what I'm saying, Papa. I can show you. I have a video clip. If... I don't mean...
I will press this phone. Go outside and press the phone. Don't press this phone.
No, I mean to show you. I know what I'm saying. I have a video clip that was sent to me this morning. I can show you.
Show again, show. Can we hear the show? Let me see what you are showing. On your show.
Not Daniela. You know what I saw?
No. No! This cannot be Daniela, my daughter. No! No! This cannot be Daniela! Nayo! Nayo! No! No! Chime! Chime!
What happened this morning?
Hello! Oh, can never be my daughter! Oh. Daniela Wamo! Hey, oh, yeah,
hold on. Keep quiet! Why are you shouting? Let me find out something. Odinaka? Tell me the truth. How come? What is the source of this video clip? How did you get this video clip?
No, it was my brother that stays in town that sent it to me.
No! Daniela Wabe! Daniela Wabo! Ewo!
Um, killer did not enter inside the room. From the look of things, there was no struggle. Her belongings were not tampered with. This is a pure case of murder and not robbery.
Yes, you're right.
I'm yet to understand what is going on here. What happened to Danny? What did she do? What crime did she commit? I don't get it. Can someone say something to me? Why would the person come and kill her just like that? Danny, on my honor, as your friend and sister, I will make sure your killer does not go unpunished. It's a promise.
Mr. Greg.
Yes.
You and your friends might be needed at the station for further clarification and questioning. Hope you don't mind.
No problem. We'll be available.
All right. Get the ambulance. We need to get to work as soon as possible.
Who killed Danny?
Danny.
Beautiful soul.
Danny, help me. Yes. Ah!
Daniela Wamo. Daniela Wamo. Hey. 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 Hey.
Who did she offend?
I don't understand. What kind of big temptation is this?
Who did she offend?
I just don't know. Why did they kill her?
Who did this? Sorry, oh.
Neka. I'm going to water right now.
Aaron. You were my brother. Take it easy. Take it easy, my brother. I would suggest you don't rush out in a haste like this. Put yourself together. First, let us study and find out exactly what happened.
I would suggest.
Please. You don't go out like this.
Why not listen to what you just said?
Because what we are seeing now, we don't want to start hearing something else.
Another story.
Yes.
You're going out in this condition. It's not too good.
It's not good.
Rest. And we look for the solution. Find out what has happened. Please.
Because this is strange.
Thank you, my elders. But I cannot rest. I have to go to Owerri. Let me go and find out exactly what happened to my daughter. Let me go and see myself. I cannot rest, elders. Namus no nyago boroni se na halahola. My father told me that a man lying with a snake coiling around his head cannot sleep. How can I rest? Let me get to Owerri. Say things to myself.
Ijoma.
Take care, please. Daddy, love one.
It's enough.
It's enough. Did she offend somebody?
Who did she offend?
What kind of temptation?
Who did she offend?
I am Jehovah.
Who killed Danny?
that young girl that is supporting her.
Hey! Hey! What your mother I have? What is the meaning of this, Bikon? Eh? This is terrible. Eh? Daniela that was building a house for the father. Eh? Wait, oh. Have you seen the house this girl was building for the father? Have you seen it?
It's obvious now, everybody will see it. The house is too big. In fact, where did she get that kind of money to build a house for the father? But the fact is,
if you ask me, who will I ask?
The fact is, people that kill that girl are wicked, very wicked souls.
Chai! Chai! Who will not get himself? This is terrible.
Whoever did this to that innocent girl will never go unpunished. I pray the person will not have rest.
He said, eh? But what of the useless husband, ex-husband?
You mean?
Because that useless man has been in my mind. Hmm? I hope he doesn't have a hand in our daughter's death.
What are you thinking?
Hey!
Too sure now. There's no evidence.
I hope.
But what I know is that time will tell. The secrets will come out.
Will come out. You are right.
It's just time.
Who did this to me? My own Daniela. Mua. Oh, you, my enemies, you think you have gotten me? Mbalo, you cannot get me. My own Daniela, that she promised to finish that house. Our own breadwinner. Daniela. Okay, they don't want her to finish the building she started to give us a level in our family. Daniela, you promised me a car, 500,000. Oh, everything. Anna. Oh, yo, who has tried me? Who is the person that is trying me? By the way, where is my brother? Ebeki Wuno. Hey! If you think you can get me like this, you take away my food from my mouth. You will have me to contend with. But Daniela is not gone. Me, Ibekwe, I will not take it. My Daniela, my Ella is not gone. My food is not gone. You can't take my food away from me and you say I will just swallow it hook, line, and sinker. Ada, I will come after you. My Daniela is not gone. She's not gone. Ibekwe, Daniela is not gone. Don't worry.
Evil man. Evil uncle. You came to confirm whether your mission was truly accomplished. You can see it. Mission accomplished. Accomplished, Gonu. Monoga accomplished, Nisigi. God will punish you. You will get to your grave. He's an evil man. He killed my daughter. He killed Daniela. He think I don't know. Don't worry. He went in and I can also know. Every iron must go through Goldsmith.
sorry about what happened. Jessica, please tell me, who do you think is behind your elder sister's death, Daniela?
I don't know. I don't know.
It's okay. You are the first person to see her corpse. So tell me everything, how it happened, you know, just talk to me, please.
She asked me to go fill up her tank at the front station.
Jessica, hurry up. Jessie,
I'm
be fast now. Okay, I have already transferred money to your account. Just go straight to the fuel station and buy the fuel. Fill up the tank. Jessica, fill up the tank and come back home straight. Did you hear that part?
Yes, ma'am.
Because I know you. Don't go around town cruising with my car. Did you hear me?
Of course I heard you.
Please, because I know you. Don't go around town cruising with my car. Please.
Yes, ma'am.
Come back. No, really, I have a birthday party to attend, so you have to come back quick.
See, sir, I've heard you.
Okay.
Jessica, don't go around town cruising with her car. Come back home early. Oh, Jessica, noted.
Please, I'm not joking, because I know you. Everything is a joke to you.
Sis, I'm coming, don't worry. I'll be back soon.
Okay. I'm making okra soup. Do you want fufu?
Sis, please, I beg in God's name, not okra, please, Egusi. Please. You know I'm allergic to okra soup.
Since
please.
When?
Okay, sis, just Egusi, please, this time. Please.
Okay,
please.
I've heard you. But you have to come back quick.
Of course I'll come back quick.
Jesse, please, I'm begging you.
Oh my goodness, I will come back quick. Okay. See, this money you sent to me, so I am going to keep some for myself.
Jesse, fill my tank.
Of course I will.
Thank you.
Silas! Is that his visitor? Silas! 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 Come on, open the gate now. Where is this guy? Silas! This guy is mad. I know he must be outside here. Very useless. I know he must be out here with his useless friends. This Silas is so useless, very useless. What am I going to do? I don't get one because of this useless boy.
I was on the queue when she called me to ask if I've gotten the file, and then asked me to go get her pizza. I'm sure you saw the pizza on the floor when you got there.
Yes, I did see it.
I can't believe that my sister is no longer alive to eat it. I can't believe it. So I got back, drove in, and saw my sister lifeless.
Kai, Omaboji, Makoki Day. Where is this useless boy? What is this? Silas! This useless boy! Wallahi, I will break this boy's head today. Can you imagine nonsense? Wallahi, if I don't break his head, call me bastard. No blame him. This Silas, I will clip his wings. Very useless. Just left the gate open like this. I no blame him. We'll deal with you. Silas, I will clip your wings. Nonsense.
They have killed Daniela, they killed your daughter, Papa.
Fred! Fred will never go away. Fred! He will never get away with this. Never! No way. Officer, Fred will not get away with this. No. I will make sure he rots in jail. Fred, we're not in jail. It's okay. My own daughter, Ella, mom, When I put our queen is he? No. Somebody should tell me it's not true. No. Okay. No, okay. No, Mama, okay.
Thank you,
I said okay.
Papa, it's okay. The police are handling it already. I believe they will fish out her killer.
Whether you are fishing out her killer or not, it is none of my business. Fred! Hey! 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 No! Officer, listen to me. Make sure you arrest that idiot. Leave no stone unturned to get him arrested. Do whatever you can. Arrest him. He must rot in jail.
Please, you have to calm down, please.
No. No, no.
Daniel!
No, no.
Daniel! No!
Papa! It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Let it just
be.
Is she not taking your call yet?
Her number is not even connecting. I don't know if she forgot to do the transfer.
Maybe her battery is flat. Just calm down.
But the truck drivers have been calling me now. I need to settle these guys.
Tell them to hold on. She will definitely send the money. Please. Enugu.
I don't even know how I'm feeling this morning. I feel so tired.
Calm down now.
Obinna! Obinna!
Obinna! Odinaka, why are you screaming my name like
Obinna.
This?
Obinna!
Naka, again.
Obinna!
Again.
Have you heard?
Heard what?
You mean you have not heard anything? You've been here since morning? You've not left this compound?
Left to where? This is my house. What do you mean left?
Odinaka, what is it now?
Odinaka, can you just calm down and tell us what happened? What's all this one you're doing now?
Mina Ella.
Did what?
Ella is dead.
I don't understand.
Ella just left here this morning. What is Ella? Is Ella just left here an hour ago?
Did you smoke anything this morning?
Obinna, I'm not joking!
Ella just left here an hour ago. Which one is Ella is dead?
Will you stop this?
Stop this! What do you mean Ella is dead? Ella just left my house now! And you're telling me she's dead?
I'm saying Ella is dead?
You think I'm joking?
Oh, then I can stop. Stop!
What kind of nonsense is this now? You jump into my house to give me this kind of nonsense news.
Okay. What's wrong with you?
It's fine. I think you guys need to see this. She was shot right this morning in her house.
I go.
You guys need to see this.
Hey! Chimo! Jesus! Jesus! Jesus Christ! Jesus!
Hey!
Ella!
I told you!
Ella!
Hey!
Ella! 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 Ella!
Ella!
Oga! Oga! Mr. Jack! Mr. Jack! Mr. Jack! Mr. Jack! Mr. Jack! I've killed Ella! Ella is dead! Ella is dead! I killed Ella! I killed Ella! They have just killed Ella! I told them not to kill her! But they will... Hey! Ella is dead! Ella is gone! I killed Ella! I told them not to kill Ella, but I want them not to kill her. I told them not to kill Ella. They killed Ella, I killed Ella. I killed Ella. I killed Ella. Ella, Ella. Ella is dead. Ella is dead. I killed Ella.
Seriously, Mama, I'm still in shock. I can't believe the Ella that visited me this morning was a ghost.
Hey!
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 I can't. Is this how people die?
Hey!
Is this how people die?
She came home in the morning without her car. We were surprised. She didn't even inform us that she was coming. She said she will come and see you and your wife. That's just it. The next thing is to show me a video clip of her death. Of her lying on the ground in a pool of blood. You know, nobody here. Who did this to my daughter? Who took her to her early grave?
Mama, just calm down, Mama. I'm sure God has a reason for everything.
What reason does God have to do this?
I don't know. I'm sure God has a reason for this.
What reason? What reason does God have to do this to me? The breadwinner of my family. Our hope. Our life, our everything. I... No. The food she said I should cook for her is still there. Let her come and eat it. Let her come and eat her food. Call Ella to come and eat her food.
Mama, it's alright.
Hey!
It's alright, Mama.
Nessie, I don't do more! Hey!
Mama, it's alright.
Hey!
It's alright, Mama.
Bao! Mba! Bao!
Who killed Annie? The beautiful soul. Who killed Annie? The beautiful soul. A lady with a heart of gold. A lady with a small.
What are you doing? Like, somebody help! Baby, wake up now. Wake up. Why are you doing this now? You want to kill me? Wake up now, please. Wake up! Somebody help! Hey!
Daniela was an exceptional colleague of mine, a hard worker. And my friend. It was actually my birthday she was planning for when the incident occurred.
I learned she was promoted in the office last month.
Oh, yes.
What kind of friends did she keep?
Few cool friends. Very good friends. Emily, Susan, Linda, and I.
Her position was higher than yours and that of your friends, I presume.
Absolutely correct. But nonetheless, we're very happy for her.
Of course, I know. You were all happy. And that's a common thing. So, how was her lifestyle with you guys in the office?
Like I said, we're good friends. Very good friends.
I see. What about the friend she once had fracas with in the office? Or don't you want to tell me about it, Mr. Greg?
Inspector, that was just a minor.
Minor? You call that minor? The girl in question is your girlfriend. Don't tell me you are trying to play a game of protection. I mean, taking your girlfriend out of the scene.
Inspector, I lost a friend and a colleague. A good friend at that. I am trying everything I can to make sure I assist you in this investigation. I told you. If there is any other way I can get information for all this, I will. Daniela was my friend. A very good one at that. And of course, I'm aware she had little issues with my girlfriend, which led to the little fracas we were talking about.
In other words, the girl was extremely jealous with Daniela, isn't it?
Extremely jealous is not how I would posit it. Extremely jealous? Oh, come on, Inspector. She knows I am in good terms with my friends and colleagues. She knows.
I see. So were you in a platonic relationship? Or, you know how colleagues develop feelings for each other. You know how it is?
Inspector, you were rather invading my privacy. And I have rights as citizen. Daniela was my friend. And whatever I had with her should be respected.
But you cheated on your friend, Susan. And don't you think that will aggravate on what we are dealing with right now? Don't you think so?
Susan will never kill Daniela.
Mr. Greg, speak for yourself.
Officer, it was just a normal fight. Friends fight. They nag, they call each other names, but that does not mean anything.
So why did you suddenly pick up a fight and creepy arguments with Daniela? Immediately she got elevated to a higher position at the same workplace. It seems you are the type that likes to fight and fall out with her, isn't it?
Everybody loved Daniela. Everybody knew that she was a very nice person. But that does not mean that I will not fight or argue with her when she does something I don't like.
Like what? Hanging out with your boyfriend? Traveling with your boss and making more money, etc., etc.
Inspector, I would never kill a friend. I won't do that. Yes, I was envious and jealous about her vast sources. But that does not mean that I will kill Daniela. No, I won't do that.
Even when she slept with Greg, your boyfriend.
Hey, babe.
Wait, what's the meaning of this? What is the meaning of... Then I'm talking to you! Okay, just look at yourself. What is the meaning of this? The meaning of four people! Eh? Out of all the girls in the world,
You chose this slot!
Susan, it's a mistake. Calm down. It's a mistake.
It's a mistake? No, you're on top of her. She came all the way from your office to the house, and you're on top of her, and you're telling me it's a mistake. Damn it! Get up! Bitch, get up! Slut! Wake up!
We are neighbors, neighbors.
You knew we are neighbors. You knew! And you're cheating on me, Greg! Oh, my goodness! What? Hey! Wait, stop! Wake up! Wake up, you're sleeping. You're sleeping in my man's room! Huh? Greg, look at you. Look at you! Look at what you turned yourself into! Don't touch me! Don't touch me, Emily, please! Daniela, how could you? How dare you? How could you do this to me?
Susan, I'm sorry.
We should go outside. We should go outside and settle this. Daniela, you are pure evil. You are so evil that I can feel it. You have an atom of human sympathy in you. How could you do this to me?
Susan, you know me too well. When I say I didn't know how this happened, believe me, I am sorry. We were drunk. I didn't even know what was happening. All I can remember is him telling me to come inside, let's have a talk. And that was it. Please, I'm sorry.
Susan, please calm down.
You're asking me to calm down. You know what? You will hear from me. And this slap I give to you is nothing compared to what I'm going to do to you. I will so deal with you, Ella. Susan. Yes! You know what? You will not live to regret what you've done to me. Susan. You will rot in hell! No wonder your husband left you. Susan. Oh, yes!
Susan, you are reaching too far.
Don't
I'm
you
sorry.
Dare tell me that! Susan. Daniela, don't worry. You will hear from me. I promise you. I will so deal with you.
Susan, I said
that you will regret the day you met me.
Daniela, how could you?
Well, I said I was freaking drunk. Did you hear that part? I was drunk, girl. I didn't know what was happening. I didn't even know what happened.
But wait, Ella. Let me ask you something. Why is he always you? Ella. Why is he always you? This is how you slept with the MD to get this promotion. Hello? Yes, Linda. And now your colleague's boyfriend. Are you not ashamed of yourself?
Stop it, Linda.
I beg.
Will you stop? What nonsense are you talking about? Heaven knows that everything I have achieved in this company, the awards, the promotion, the special treatment, whatever be it, is through hard work. I have worked for it. Maybe you should learn to work hard and then see if they will not promote you.
Linda, if you don't have anything to say to help sort out the issue, just shut it. Don't say things that will aggravate the matter already. Ella, so what do we do now? How do we sort out this mess?
There is no how to sort it out. No. Are you going to unsex our man?
What is wrong with you?
I asked a question. Are you going to unsex our man? No. You've achieved your aim. Title. The next title to you now is now what? Boyfriend snatcher. That is your new title.
Achievement title. Kudos to you. Ella,
you know I am not this person. On a good day, I will not do this. I said I was drunk.
Look, I am not doubting the explanation you gave before. But the question now is, how do we sort out this mess we are in?
I mean, seriously, I don't know.
You wanted that position. But unfortunately, you didn't get it. It was rather given to a hard-working Daniela.
Inspector, you're crossing the line. This is a murder case, not my personal life. I did not kill Ella. As a matter of fact, everyone wanted that.
You wanted that position. True or false?
Yes, but that does not mean I killed Ella. I did not kill my...
You killed your colleague out of jealousy and envy.
Inspector, I did not kill Ella.
Stop yelling.
I did not kill
Ella. Stop
yelling else, I will put you behind bars. Some time ago, you celebrated your birthday where Daniela was poisoned. Can you tell me about it?
Inspector, everything happened so fast. I was waiting for my cake to be delivered. We're just toasting and discussing about my gift. She started coughing. At first, we thought it was just maybe choking or something. We requested water. She said she was fine. She didn't want to take the water. All of a sudden, she started coughing up blood.
Don't you think you used your birthday party as a disguise to poison Daniela because you wanted her position?
Inspector, your questions are beginning to choke me. Birthdays are meant to be celebrated with family, colleagues, and friends. And that was exactly what I did.
Young lady, can you answer my question? Did you by any way advise your friend to leave her marriage?
The marriage was toxic. She was dying in silence. She doesn't talk to anyone except me.
Toxic. The marriage was toxic. Do you think Fred is responsible for the death of his ex-wife?
I don't think so. But I know so.
Why do you say so?
A lot of times I visited them. I spoke to them. I did my best for them to always iron out their issues. Until this particular day.
So your insult has gotten to the point.
No.
But you have to go to my photocopy number, right?
I swear, I did not take your phone. I did not touch your phone. I did not take any number, I swear.
Who called Angela and warned her to stay clear from me? Who did?
I don't know. I did not touch your phone. I did not. I don't know what you're talking about. I swear.
Ella, I can see death is calling you.
Fred, please, I did
Ella,
not.
Death is calling you, Fred, and I will help you, Fred, to answer that call.
Fred,
I will help you decide that to humiliate me in this house. Idiot! Try this time, animal!
Victory, right? Do you know what you've done? Do you really know what you've done? I am asking you.
Emily, you're in my space.
and you're disturbing my home.
So what if it's your space? If the world is scared of you, I can never be scared of you. You are a monster!
Stop that, Emily! This is my home! This is my space! Don't talk to me like that! Who are you to talk to me in such manners?
When you're about to raise your hand and hit me, if you try it, I will let you know that I am the devil's scorn. I am not your wife. Hit me if you're not scared. If you've ever been referred to as a man, hit me. How dare you? How dare you, animal? You hit your wife to your point that she miscarried.
Did you just say miscarried? Where is she, please? Please, where is she, please?
Take your hands off me.
Please, where is she, please?
Take it out!
Can you tell me where she is, please? Talk to me, where is she?
Disgusting beast.
Honey, please. Please forgive me. I know I've erred. But please, I don't even know what happened to me. I don't, it's like evil spirit took hold of me. But please, I'm sorry. Biko, forgive me. Eh? And I'm not worthy to be called your husband again. Amy, please now, help me beg her. Oh, Biko. Please, Biko, please. Honey?
Huh? Danny, let's leave this place already. It stinks.
Don't touch it, honey. Don't touch it. Leave it back alone, honey, please now. Honey, please. My love, please. Biko, please.
Ella, let's
please. Please, forgive me. Please, honey, I'm sorry, honey. Please, honey. Biko, honey. Please, now I can't live without you. Honey, please. Biko. Honey, baby. Please now. Honey. Baby. Please. Biko. Please, Biko, honey, please now, honey, Biko, please, I can't live without you, honey, please, honey, Biko, honey, please, honey, please,
don't worry, let me get it,
honey, Biko, honey, babe, honey.
What's wrong with you, Daniela? What is the matter with you? Daniela, do you want to die? Do you want that guy to kill you?
No, please. Emily, stop. Nobody is dying. God forbid, nobody is dying in first marriage. Please, really, you don't understand.
I don't understand what?
You don't understand marriage and how it works.
I will not understand. What do you want me to understand exactly? That a woman should stay back and die in her marriage, even when it's obvious that it's not working.
Emily, no one is dying in my marriage, God forbid.
Daniela, come on! What is it? That guy punches you at every little mistake. He hates you. He doesn't value you, he doesn't cherish you, he doesn't even care for you. You take care of that guy, you do everything, yet...
Emily, can you stop? Really, what do you want me to do? Babes, do you realize that this is my second marriage and it's not even up to 6 months? Yes!
Wow.
What's going on? You want me to quit this one? Do you want me to walk away?
We are still on this.
Of course I am. Because what do you think people would say? But what do you think people would say about me? Tongues will wag. My church will talk. My family will talk. The workplace here will talk. How do you think they would see it? Everybody will blame me. They will say I am the problem because Fred is not the first. He's the second. And it's not even up to 6 months and I'm walking away again.
Stop it! Please stop it.
Please.
Hold on, I just want to think for a while. So I am here being worried about my friend. And all you care about is what people would say. Your colleagues, your church members, family, people that might not even matter, people that will still talk when you drop dead.
And nobody is dropping dead. Please,
come on,
stop.
Daniela, will you stop it?
You know what? I understand you're trying to look out for your friend. I get it and I appreciate it, babes. But really, you have never been married.
You are beginning to sound like an educated illiterate at this point.
I am sorry if you see this as an insult.
No, it's not.
I am only saying when you get married, babes, you will understand everything I've been trying to say. And baby girl, I am praying for you. God will bless you with your own marriage. And then you would understand everything I have been trying to make you understand. Come on. I have to try. I have to. I can't just give up because of something happened.
Daniela, stop it.
Babes, I'll be coming over to your place later to pick up my things. Thank you.
Just like that. You want to come and pick up your things and go back to that monster? Daniela, you're more than a friend to me, and that is the reason I am worried about you. Daniela, that guy is a monster. He's a beast. That guy that just walked off that door is not meant for you. He's not good for you. What manner of man hits his wife till she miscarries? What is it? Daniela, please, don't do this. I am begging you with every affection and love I have for you.
Really, I understand.
You don't.
I totally understand. And trust me, he will never try it again. He will not do it again. He made a promise to me.
He has promised you countless
and
times.
And this time around, I believe him because he meant it. Babes, please. I am not stupid. I know what I am doing. I am trying to see how I can make this work.
But I don't think you do.
I cannot just give up. Not when I encounter a little problem in my marriage, I just walk away. Do you know how many men I will end up marrying at the end of my life? Babes, at the end of the day, we are all human. Fred is a human.
Couch.
And humans make mistakes. And you do not hold their mistakes against them for life. You
Daniela,
have to forgive.
This is intentional wickedness. Okay, fine. You want to go back to him. But let me remind you that it's not up to a week that you left that man.
Amy, I'm, like I said.
No, don't say nothing anymore. It's not even to a week, and you're already coming to my house to pack your luggage and go back to him again.
Amy, I know you're looking out for me. You're just trying to protect your friend. And I appreciate this. I appreciate you for it. But trust me, girl, I know what I am doing. Okay? Please.
I feel so much pity for you. Looking at you, all I could do is just
point out. Like, I feel like crying for you. But it's fine. If that's what you want, it's okay. But don't call me when both of you start making troubles again. I will not answer you, Daniela.
Babes, nobody's making any trouble. There won't be need for me to call you to come settle any case because none is happening. I love you, babes. I know you're looking out for me. All I need you to do for me is pray for my marriage. Prayers, prayers, happiness. Are you going to hang by hand?
Yes, just...
You're going to hang it?
Take it down.
Okay. Somebody is really, really angry. You were saying?
This file is from Geo Group of Companies. You know what to do with it.
I love you, babes.
Ella, tell us the truth. Tell us the truth of your life. Why did you change your next of kin from your blood sister to your husband? Tell us.
Not like I owe anyone any explanation. But I will answer this question out of respect that I have for two of you as my parents. First of all, Papa, I am a married woman. So I don't understand what the issue is here. Don't I have a right to change my status? I mean, don't I have a right to change my next of kin from my sister to my husband? After all, the Bible says that two came together to become one. That is what you taught me as a Christian. This is a Christian home. My husband is part of me. So me changing my next of kin to my husband, how is it wrong? How did I offend anyone? What is this meeting for?
It's a lie, yo. It's a lie. Sister, it's not fair. All this thing that you're saying like this is not fair. It's not fair at all. It's not fair on me, yo. It's not fair on me. I'm your sister, your only sister, your blood sister for that matter. How can you remove my name as your next of kin and just put in the name of a total stranger? For crying out loud, is your husband your family? No, I'm asking you, is he your blood? Is he your blood? Do you share any blood relation with him? I am your sister, I am your blood. I am the only sister you have in this world. In fact, the only sibling you have in this world. So it's very unfair that you remove my name and swap my name with his own. It's not nice. It's not nice though. Papa, talk to her. Talk to her. You better go and change my name back. Go and change my name back, dear now. Go and change my name back. I've been with you. I've been with you from the beginning of time till now. You cannot do this to me.
Really? Are you done? No, Jessica, are you done talking? Papa, did you hear her? No, Mama, did you hear your daughter insult me now? Did you see the way she spoke to me? No, it's the level of entitlement for me. It's your level of entitlement for me. Like, Jessica, what do you want? What have I not done for you as your elder sister? Really? Are you not about to go for youth service? Who trained you to that level, Jessica? Who trained you up to that level? And here you are giving me conditions. Telling me what to do and what not to do because I used your name in the first place. That's why you have the effrontery to open your mouth and tell me how to change my status and how not to change my status. Are you insane? Mama kun nafia. Okunu nafia.
Hi. Daniela mechikwe nonu. Zukwani ke. Cherekwa nonu ke wine kete. Oh, gene. Do you know your problem? You don't take correction.
At all.
You don't admit your fault. That's just your problem.
Mama, so this is all you will say. Now, no, Hakim will equal.
Ha. Yes. That is what she could say, and she has said it all. Because once any person takes the very first step wrongly, subsequent steps will be wrong. At first, I never liked that man. at all. You went ahead. You took that wrong step and you've been following up that step wrongly. Yet you went ahead and married him without we knowing. You willed all your belongings to him. I'll tell you this. Any day that man kills you, I will not accept your corpse in this compound. The bees sting the very head that stirred them, that alerted them. Have it in mind. And that is all I have for you. Just continue. Continue fooling yourself. Keep on fooling yourself in the name of marriage. Because this is no love. This is not love.
I have made up my mind. I have made this decision and I am not going back on it. Nobody, no Jupiter on this earth will make me change my mind.
That is it. That is what you are so good at. Making up your mind. You make it fire yourself. Making up your mind. You are good at it.
See, it will not even work. Oh. Let me just tell you, that one is a big lie. It will not work. What are you saying? Look, listen to yourself. Does it even make sense to you? If you have changed my name with the name of a child you bettered, I would understand that, okay, yes, your child is your blood. But how is your husband your relation? No, tell me now, tell me. You better go and change it back, oh. Go and change it back. Just go and change it back, because you know what? You cannot just displace me like that. You cannot replace me, oh. Go and change it back. After you have said all this, you have said them, just go and change it back. Just go and change it back.
Jessica, can I ask you a question?
Eh?
No, really. I'm not angry. Sincerely, I need you to answer me. What is your problem?
My problem is my name that you remove. My problem is my name. Just remove it. Remove that man's name and put my name back. Finish.
You have a problem with me removing your name as next of kin?
Yes.
That is your problem?
Yes.
Then Jessica, that begs me to ask you the second question. Are you praying for me to die?
How can I be praying for you to
no,
die?
No, I should be asking because...
Mama, hear what she's
saying
now.
First of all, Mama, I do not understand what this meeting is all about. Is it that you people are praying for me to die?
Okay, just say what you're
saying. No, because we are talking about next of kin. Is it not when I die that this will come to effect?
Mm-hmm.
So, you people are actually praying for me to die. Emily,
nobody's praying
my
for
family
to
is actually nobody's praying for me to die. No, what else do you want me to say? Because I do not understand what all this nonsense is all about. No. This is beginning to look like there is something else to it. Are you praying for me to die? Because I don't understand why me changing my next of kin to my husband is a problem.
Emily, you're not saying anything.
What do you want me to say? What exactly do you want me to say, Danny?
Come on.
Everything that you exhibited, it clearly shows you're the boss. So if I say something, will it matter?
Come on, Emily, cut me some slack. Come on. You know I'm trying for my family.
What?
You know, I try for them.
What did you just say?
I say I try for them and you know this.
Just shut it, Danny. Shut it. Tell me one thing you've done for your parents other than training your younger one in school. Tell me.
Hold on, Emily. I don't understand. What are you talking about?
What I am saying is that whatever it is you've done for your parents should not be mentioned. Yes. And how could you? How could you even think of using who? Fred as your next of kin. Danny, come on. How can you be this pretty with no brains?
Come on, Emily, don't. What is your problem? Don't you understand? This man is my husband.
A husband that punches you at every given opportunity.
That was then. The guy has changed. And he said he's not going to do it again. And I believe him. Right now, we are cool. We are loving. We're fine.
How come you're my friend and I never realized how daft you were? That man, that monster has promised never to hit you seven times. Has he stopped? Okay, I will still be counting.
Emily, I know you're looking out for me. And I know you care about me. But you have to understand that I am not daft. I am not stupid. I know exactly what I am doing.
Your attitude says otherwise.
Babes, you know what? If you were married, we would be having this conversation. But it's quite unfortunate you're not. So you will not understand what marriage is all about. You have to keep trying. You don't just quit like that.
You keep rubbing into my face that I am not married.
It's not an insult. I'm just trying to make you understand that you're not getting it. And I wish you were on... You know what?
You're foolish. How can you... You are being foolish. You sound daft. You sound stupid.
Do you know you're the only one who can actually talk to me like this and I let it slide? No one. No one there.
It's unfortunate. I feel so sad that all of this is happening, yet your number six is fluctuating. It's not even fluctuating. Your number six is empty.
Emily, can you stop?
Stop what?
Stop insulting me.
I am not insulting you. I am telling you the obvious.
Babes, you are insulting me. You are. And I know you love me. And babes, I really appreciate, but you have to stop. I am not stupid. I know what I am doing. Come on. I don't even know what the fuss is all about.
It's clear. It's clear to me that this is not just love. I mean... Come on. Are you sure that man did not hypnotize you? Because you're not... You've lost it.
Just stop, please. Come on. I can't believe you're sounding
but
this way.
But it's not funny.
It is. What are you talking about? Babe, I know. I know you... Oh, God. Emily, I appreciate you. I love you. But trust me... Ah, really? Well, you have no choice. You have to love me. You have to...
Listen, your parents will never mislead you. I cannot mislead you.
No, seriously, Emily, stop. Please. Fred is my husband. And trust me, everything is fine. Everything is okay.
You, your boxer of a husband? The one that uses you as a weapon. Listen, it's funny, but it's crazy how I keep fighting. How all of us keep fighting for a beautiful woman who got no brains.
Honey, judging from your countenance, your family did not like the idea, right?
Does it matter now?
Honey, I'm sorry. I am deeply sorry. Please.
What have I not done for you? What in this world have I not done for you? For your sake, I have disobeyed my family countless times. I have turned deaf ears to my friends and family. To everyone, just to make you happy.
Babe, I
am not done talking.
That's okay.
What is this?
Is this?
Oh, shut it! You and I know that I do not wear black on this! Fred, what in God's name is this doing in your car? Because that's exactly where I found it. Gosh!
Honey, please, do not allow this.
To think that I will do M
anything for you! Gosh.
Please, I...
Okay. Don't let this... Oh, well, please, shut it! Shut your mouth! I do not want to hear anything from you! What is your problem? No, really, what is the color of your problem, Fred? I am here trying everything possible to build this marriage, but you are sitting majestically trying to tear it down. What is your problem?
Honey, if...
Just shut it!
Just let it... Don't...
Know that your man is a he-goat who goes after everything under the skirt, even yourself. Moreover, you asked me to monitor a certain girl called Angela to know if she does it with your man. Now my question, of what use would that information be to you? Because the last time I checked, you've always managed to put up with his excesses. So I think you should live with it.
Emily, all I said is I saw a black...
You saw a black what? Black what? Black bra, pink pants, yellow condom, rainbow color women underwear. What are you even talking about? Is this the first time you're seeing those things in his car? Of course not. And this will not be the last. Moreover, why are you even telling me this?
Why am I telling you this? Emily, because you're my friend. You're the only one I can talk to. You don't expect me to talk to people who will mock me at the end of the day.
Stop it. Just stop. You want us to go about this again? Have you forgotten what you told me? You said, and I quote, "I can handle it." So what? Are you tired of handling it?
Please stop.
My friend, just go on, go. You can't handle it. You've been doing that.
Oh, fine, Emily. It's okay. It's okay.
Of course.
Before you crucify me. I'm not going to talk about my marriage again. No more complaints.
Beautiful.
How about we go for lunch?
Nah, I'm not hungry.
Really? Okay, how about a drink?
I've got lots of workload on my table.
Really?
See you later, baby girl.
Babes, come on, you're taking this thing too far.
Enjoy your lunch.
Emily, let's go. I don't want us to stay here.
But we just got here. Why?
I don't feel like... I mean, you know what? Let's go home. Let's just
come
go
on,
home.
This place
come
is...
on, let's go home. Let's go. Emily, please. Please. Please.
Oh. Now I see. So, this is the reason you don't want us to stay here.
Please, can we go? Please.
Well, you see, this is just the beginning. I will make sure I spoil your life. Make your life as beautiful as you. Yeah?
Thank you.
You're less welcome because I have a special place in my heart. Yeah?
Hello, hello! Friend's husband. Hello! And side chick. Hi. Actually, we came here to hang out. When I said we, I hope you understand the plural, right? We actually came to hang out, but I can see that our next of kin is having good time with this whore, so we decided to change our location.
I beg your pardon? How dare you?
You didn't follow me to talk?
and they talk, you they open your mouth. What you ask? How they? Now me they speak English for? You they mad? You they crazy? You know, no sir, be worried, babe. For worry, what is that they come in a ratata? You do anyhow, you collect anyhow. Talk now, if you're not there, your body talk. Talk now. Oh, you didn't fear to talk. Oh.
If you ever say that to me again, you will regret your low life.
Eh?
Emily,
me, Waiting! Me, Emily, worry again.
Emily, will you
say what happened?
Hey,
talk!
Emily,
I am trying to respect myself. Don't try to respect what?
It's okay, let's go. It's okay.
Wait, I need to teach this girl a lesson.
Hey! It's okay.
It's okay.
Danny, leave me, let me shut that girl.
Don't get me angry. Get your bag, let's go. Get your bag, let's leave.
That mad dog. Don't allow this affect this our beautiful mood, okay? What else do you want?
Fred, leave me alone. Leave me alone.
Ella!
Just leave me alone. Let me have peace in this house. Leave me alone now. What is it?
Ella!
Leave me alone.
How dare you, Ella? Huh? How dare you, Ella?
Fred, I don't know what you're talking about. Just leave me alone.
You brought your friend to humiliate me, Ella.
I really don't know what you're talking about.
You brought your friend to humiliate me.
Leave me.
Huh? You disgrace me in public. How dare you, Ella?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't know what I'm talking about.
I don't know what you're talking about. Did not send anybody to anywhere.
Ella, you brought your friend to disgrace me. Then you had the guts to walk into my house, under my roof, to live with me. Ella.
Fred, just leave me alone. Leave me alone. Let me have peace in this house.
Ella, you must leave the house. You must leave my house, I swear.
Hey!
Ella, I will leave, leave my house. If you're aware, you'll leave my house. You brought your friend to humiliate me, yet you walked into my house again to live with me. Idiot.
I can see you had quite an outstanding relationship with Ella.
She was more like a sister to me. After that night, I pleaded with her never to go back to that marriage. But my friend was in love. She never listened to me. I was afraid Fred could kill her and take away everything she has labored for since her parents already disowned her.
It's okay.
I was everything, literally everything she has.
Here, it's okay. Here, you can have this.
My daughter, there is this saying that goes like this, that a dying dog does not perceive the smell of excreta anymore. There is nothing anybody will say or do here now that will make me change my mind. None of my family members will go to stay with Ellen. Nobody will even visit. So Jessica cannot go to stay with her. And nobody from my family will even pay a visit.
Papa, I understand how messy everything is. But Danny is still your daughter. Your first fruit, Papa. Please, I am begging you.
You are saying something else. I am not disputing that fact. She is my daughter. As a matter of fact, my very first daughter. So, I am not disputing that fact.
Papa, I am begging you. I brought myself before you. I am humbling myself before you and Mama. Hence the reason I am here. To please allow Jessica to go stay with her. Because I believe that if she's there with her, Fred would not treat her as badly as he would when there is no one there. Please, Papa, temper justice with mercy.
Emilia, as beautiful as you are, I want to believe that your ears are not for fancy. You're not deaf. You heard me right. I have told you. So there is no amount of plea that will make me have a change of mind. I have just told you. And that is that. Because I warned her earlier about that snake that calls himself Fred. He went ahead and married Fred.
Mama, you're a woman. You're Danny's mother. And I believe you understand better. I also believe you know what to do so that Papa can calm down. Mama, please, I am begging you. Danny is going through a lot in that house. Danny is in hell. Do something before it is too late.
My daughter, you have spoken a lot. You know, Ella has refused to listen to her father and I. She has broken our hearts in many ways and many times. I know what we passed through. What we went through to make sure she had education. She was intelligent right from child. She was hardworking. That's why we made everything possible to make sure she get to her dream. But what did we get in return? I was there on Obakana. That is true. Check it now. We just got empty-handed.
No.
She took us for fools.
No, Mama.
No bewu kaibo. I bewu. Nah. Nah.
Mama.
That's the parents of Ella before her.
Mama.
Everything goes to her husband now. She keep buying everything, properties, everything. Willing everything to her husband. I am abusing the baby. No problem. No problem. We are fools. There's nothing we can do.
Mama, I understand. I know that everything she's doing is not good. Hence the reason I am here, because I cannot do it alone. I alone will not be able to caution her. Someone needs to assist me so we will be able to curtail her excesses. Mama, please. Mama, please, I am begging you.
I don't give a damn. No matter the number of millions she is making or properties she is buying or giving to whoever, it doesn't matter. I don't care. I'm a grown woman. Yes. I'm a grown woman. But I can't read you out for that she was a woman man that wrote them. This is me. I can tell you I am satisfied while I'm still hungry. Instead of me to eat, if I overfeed myself and end on the way, I will become hungry, I remain hungry, but let me get home alive and safe. Do you understand? Alas, matter. I don't care. I don't want to know whatever is happening. All I'm saying is, Daniela is a minus in this family. She's gone, she's gone.
Nne. Ella is our daughter. And we love her so much. Believe me, we so much love her. Please, I am appealing to you to continue talking to her. Do not leave her side. We have done everything best, but she refused to listen to us. So there's nothing we can tell Ama that will make her change her mind over our words. No, it's true. But I believe in you. I believe she will listen to you someday. Because it is said that a mad person has who he or she listens to. Biko, I believe that one day she will come back to her senses. Continue talking to her. Biko, one more. Don't be angry.
You see, if she's pleading or whatever, I am not part of that. I'm not pleading, I can't beg for anything or whatsoever. But I thank God that Jessica has been able to finish her education. If Fred had come into her life earlier, before now, Jessica would have been a dropout. But I thank God she has finished. So the rest, I'll leave it for God. What I'm saying is, I don't want to interfere or intrude in her sweet marriage. Let her go ahead.
So, what is this?
She's pregnant. And it's for my husband.
She's pregnant. And it's for your husband. This is good news. Look at her face. This is beautiful. Interesting. Oh my God. And do you know what he will do? He will throw your ass out with nothing. Bring in the bitch and you will do no shit. Because you have never done shit and you will never do shit. Look at you. Beauty without brains. You want me to pity you? Is that what you want from me? I will not give you that pity you are looking for. Your parents went through thick and thin to make you become the woman you are today. And how did you pay them back? By forsaking them because of one stupid, God-forsaken son of Adam. Daniela. Wait. Is this why you invited me to your office? Congratulations.
What is strong? Why is her number not connecting? Angela, you don't have a second line. Come on, Jella, put on your phone. It's switched off. I thought you said you're going to spend a night at your friend's place, so why did you come back?
I came back to pick up a few things.
A few things?
Yes.
Are you going for a holiday?
Why are you pretending like you don't like it? Well, I decided to give you and your mistress some space because I figured you would be needing it.
A mistress? Which mistress are you talking about?
Kirin.
Hey.
It's okay. Come in. No. Come in.
You're welcome. And sit. Come on, sit down. Make yourself comfortable. We've been expecting you.
You said she was going to work.
Yes, but I'm as shocked as you. So shocked. I'm surprised.
With this lady set up, we can stay here. We can't.
So she's going to divorce her husband.
Well, it looks like it, but I am not sure.
See, I know that he impregnated that girl and deliberately beat my sister up until she had that miscarriage. Yes, he did that because he knows he's a next of kin. He wants to kill her now and inherit all her properties. You think I don't know?
Jessica, the truth is you might be right. But the beautiful thing is, your sister has promised to take care of you and your parents.
Do you know she has changed my name back?
Slow down. Like I said, the beautiful thing now is that she has promised to make sure you people don't lack anything. Most importantly, she said she would build a house for you and your parents. Befitting one. So I can say that's a good one.
No, it's good.
It's a good one.
I'm very happy. She's your friend. Be talking to her. She has to change my name back.
What would you do? I don't talk to her.
Well, what are you two gossiping about?
Mama. I want to go and see if I'm coming back.
Okay. She even asked me about you.
Are you serious? Yes. How about Obinna? Anyway, don't worry. We talk every day. Madam, let's go now. You don't want to go.
Madam, Njokwan.
Mama, I dash you.
Emmy, don't forget what we discussed. Don't forget.
Of course I will not. Jessica.
And what did you people discuss?
How is that supposed to be your business?
Anyway, as long as you're not selling my father's house, let's go. Mama, I'm coming.
Mama, we'll see you next time, okay? Alright, see you. Bye.
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 It's okay.
Daniela, my friend, can we work in with you? Marriage is not easy. Marriage is just there. No marriage is made of gold and diamond. Well, then if you want to leave, my dear, how sure are you that the next one will be okay? So what would you do? Stay and manage.
You know, when you don't know or have what to say, it's better sometimes to just keep your mouth shut. Huh? What's this blah, 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 blah you're saying? I don't understand. What are you saying? Marriage is a living hell. Are you living in hell?
Is this on marriage? I'm asking you, is this for marriage? A man that cannot bring penny? No, wait. When did you buy something for me last?
What are you saying? Are you trying to tell me I do not take good care of you? Eh? Is there anything you've requested of me that I didn't do for you?
Okay. Those okrika that you buy for me, Abi. Those things you buy for me, okrika, are those ones clothes? No, take a good look at her. Look at Daniela. She's looking all beautiful. Look at her. Even if your husband beats you and still gives you everything, Omakan, it's good. It's no problem.
I don't understand. Why do you think that way?
What is that? Are you married? No, are you married? I'm asking you, are you married? Kera Kodieha.
It's okay, please. It's okay, because I really don't understand what the fuss is all about. I can't remember telling anybody that my husband beats me or hurts me. Biko, usiziano. But at the same time, I agree with Obinna. Huh? Obinna is right.
Thank you.
A lot of sense. I made sense
my
too.
Friend, keep quiet. Keep quiet. Wait. Just close your mouth.
Did somebody talk?
Daniela, on a more serious note, you know I always tell you the truth. If your husband hits you in that house, I'm begging you, please, come back to this village.
Yeah.
I'm sure your father will accept you back into his house. If his burial is next tomorrow, and you know what happened to her? Her husband slapped her and she slumped and died. So please, I will not want to hear this kind of story. Yo. I won't want this to happen to my own friend. My friend, no, I won't take it. My friend, will you keep quiet? Shut up. Stop saying all the things you're saying. Sometimes, keep quiet. Eh? There are people here.
It's okay, please. It's okay.
Please, oh. Please, listen to what I've just told you. Nice. Think about it, oh.
It's okay. Nothing will happen to me. I'm fine, okay?
I know what I'm saying.
How are you poo doing?
Everything is fine, apart from her behavior. I understand. Maybe it's pregnancy. I understand. No, I understand. Seriously, I understand. I'm sure it's the pregnancy that's making her talk like this.
Exactly. No, it's the pregnancy. If I'ma calm down.
You're looking good.
Why won't she look good?
Huh? Thank you. You look good too.
Who killed Danny? The beautiful soul. Who killed Danny? A lady with a heart of gold, a lady with a spot, a philanthropist, Daniela, 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 the beautiful. Who killed Daddy?